three songs, three different regions that you'll need to love. Right about now, we talk about virtual reality. Walid and Maria are here to talk about this amazing expression of technology and art. Good morning, lady and gentlemen.
Morning.
Yeah, it's such an honor to actually have you. I've heard of your story for over a month now, and I was talking to one of my friends called Fladwell, and I was like, you need to bring these people to the studio. I'm like, I'm not going to bring them. No, I'm kidding. It's just that I did not understand what it was. So, yeah. Walid, brief introductions of who you are and then into the invention.
Great. Thank you for having us. My name is Walid Kilonzi. I'm a virtual reality producer at Fallowhead. We're based in Westlands. So we kind of just came together and decided as a company to kind of train artists to make virtual reality art, more specifically virtual reality graffiti. And that's why Maria is here with us today.
Also, thank you for having me. My name is Maria Gekuro, art name Wamagi. I'm a visual artist. So traditionally I do painting, illustrations, and also I work as a graphic designer.
Okay. That's exciting. First of all, traditional art is one of the most coveted one. Like we'd get the Picasso, the Da Vinci, the Salvador Dali's of the moments, and everything would go on canvas. Why is it that people have decided to translate that? Maybe Walid, you talk to me about that, and then you tell me about how the learning experience has been.
Great. I mean, it's your traditional way of doing art has become I think widespread, even with the spread of mobile phones. But the fact that you can do your artworks within a 3D space, I think that brings in a new way of, and a new challenge for artists to be able to get into that virtual world, and not just a virtual world, but also the metaverse. There are not many Africans in that, so we're also trying to get as many artists, as many people to kind of just be able to have fun as we share our toys and stuff like that.
So just share with me how the experience has been, because he talks about metaverse, we are still in universe. we want to touch things, make things tactile. I know you miss the brush and the strokes and everything, but how different is it for you, and how has the learning experience been?
Okay, learning was very interesting. It was fascinating. I didn't even know what was I was going to expect. I thought I was going to bring my art tools and everything, and then he just told me, just bring yourself. And I was like, how am I going to make art like that? So I realized we are going to make the artwork in virtual reality, in that space. So the first thing was just getting used to how immersive it is, because it's like a new dimension, literally. And the controls, now using controls like this one.
Okay, you can just simulate. Yeah, those are the controls.
So these are like generally the controls. So with that app, there's specific like buttons you're supposed to press. So it would emulate a canister. So you'd spray, and then it will appear on the virtual wall, but in real life, it just looks like you're spraying air.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, and it's really awkward, because the first time I played games with that,
yeah.
You have to put on the headset.
Yeah.
Do you call it the headset?
What
do you
call it? This is what we call a VR headset. Specifically, this is what we call the Oculus Quest 2, or now known as the Meta Quest 2, one of the best headsets in the market.
This one?
Yes.
I'm going to rob you.
Yeah.
You're saying the best in the market. Yeah. I'll just be out there and I'll be, hey, deal na, hey. But it's exciting how now the translation of that into technology and how people are embracing it. Now, how do I buy your art? Because Kitambo Mgenda, you tell me this is 170,000 and actually hand it over to me.
Mm.
By losing the tactile nature of it, like you can't feel it. Are people actually receptive to this form of art and buying this form of art? And how can I buy this form of art?
I can still translate. I can still bring it back to reality. So I can convert the artwork into an image that can be printed, like on a big scale on a wall, or even just like small cards. It can still come back into reality. And also digitally, we can do something called augmented reality. Mm-hmm. Where now we can kind of
Kizungu tu naongea.
Augmented
reality, it's just English.
But the power of augmented reality is that even when you have publications, comic books, stuff like that, you can bring it to life now with this technology.
Okay.
Yeah, and augmented reality is quite simply placing digital objects onto physical objects. So Best example is Instagram filters. Mm-hmm. So you're able to see flowers when somebody's taking a selfie or stuff like that. We can now scan an artwork and put digital assets, maybe like a video or a 3D model and stuff like that. So the artworks in VR, when they translate into publications or like print, they can easily be, we can also put augmented reality and make them more interactive.
That's really exciting. Now, what's the market like? Because so many people want to know now, if I get into such a space, then what's the utilization? How can I utilize this on a day-to-day basis? Because I need that kit. You've said it's the best in the world.
Yeah.
I'm sure it's not cheap cheese. Yeah. It's quite some cheddar. So just talk to us about what you think about it in general.
So we did this in partnership with an NGO called Jenga.
Stop Council. Mentioning names. You'll pay me. Like, oh, this NGO. No, it's okay.
Yeah. So Jenga Culture is an amazing space at Embakasi, and they hosted us. And what we decided with them is that we just take four artists and give them our VR headsets and let them make artworks. So, of course, we trained them before we actually gave them the headsets. And when we were doing that, of course, we had showcases. We had one at Baraza, another at Alliance, and another at iHub. And all while we were doing all that, we were training the artists to sell this idea and the fact that you can actually print it and put it on a T-shirt. Or still, sell, there's a market whereby in the virtual reality world, you can sell your artworks. It's not just a thing whereby it's mainly for like export or like for outside, but you can also, a client could ask, hey, could you make this artwork? The artist can decide to do it in virtual reality. That's why we come in. We want to assist as many artists as possible to get this. We'll share our toys, we'll train you, and we'll assist you in kind of empowering you economically to pitch it and to be able to ask for good money.
Free training, right?
Yeah, it's free.
For real?
Yes.
Tell them how they can get that. We love free things.
Yeah.
We love cheap thrills. Yeah. Free.
So currently on our socials, we're putting out very many like events after this. We're going to give out trainings, not just for virtual reality, but also augmented reality.
Mm-hmm.
We're also going to try to connect this artist to international markets, which we already have for these four artists.
Mm-hmm.
And we're really excited to kind of just pump in and create capacity within that space. And kind of tell people like, hey, we Africans are also in this space and we make crazy stuff too.
Yeah, thank you so much. Maria, you have like a parting shot to the artists out there who are trying to actually find out what you're saying.
And I just want to urge all the artists, if you see an opportunity, any projects, just try it out. Like this, I tried it out. I didn't even expect I'll be doing VR. And here I am.
Does your stability also apply in that world?
Yeah.
For
it's, real? It's like spraying for real.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because me, Najua, me and my hands are a little bit clumsy. Maria, thank you so much for creating time to talk to us. Also, Waleed.
Mm.
I know this thing is going to go global.
Yeah.
And you're going to make inventions that are going to be spread across the world. So
yeah.
I take pride in that.
Thank you so much.
Thank you
so much. Okay. Meskia, make sure that you go get your hands on that. If you want to game, if you want to just do a lot of things in virtual reality, maybe. They'll share some more platforms. Follow me at @Brian_Sali. I'll share something about what they're doing, maybe the demonstration of it for about 10 seconds, so that you get to know exactly what we are talking about. We're going to take a short commercial break as we pay some bills. Kare is an author and mental health advocate. She has an amazing book. It's out. I want to talk books.